Pattern shop, and today I'm going to show you how to make the convertible cuffs on the Toasty Toes pajama pattern. This pattern is available at peekabooPatternShop.com. So these pajamas have cuffs that can be worn just like a regular cuff, or you can fold the cuff down to make a little footie that covers the entire foot. And the pattern also includes an option to do the same thing with the sleeves. Let's go ahead and get started. For each cuff, you're going to have two pieces. Cuff A is the longer piece and cuff B is the shorter piece. So the first thing you need to do is fold cuff A in half with wrong sides together. Since my fabric looks the same on both sides, I just marked the wrong side with a few squiggles of washable marker so you can see the difference. So we're going to fold this in half with wrong sides together. I'm going to line up the ends down at the bottom, and then you're going to fold the top edge over at the marked lines from your pattern piece. Now you're going to take piece B, make sure it's right side facing up. Here's my wrong side with the squiggles. I'm going to lay your folded piece A on top of it, and then fold the top edge over. I think I had that folded quite in the right spot. So your edges should all meet up at the top. So here's my piece B folded over, looks like this on the other side. And in between, here's cuff A with the folded edge. And you want this fold to be right at the top. And then you just sew it together on both edges. So I already sewed one cuff together and I'm ready to turn it right side out. So when you turn it right side out, you need to make sure you have three layers of fabric on one side and one on the other. If you turn it right in the middle, your cuff is going to be inside out. This is the wrong side of my fabric. So make sure you have three layers, not right in the middle, but see here we have one, two, three layers of fabric, one on this side. And we'll turn it right side out. And you want the cuff to be open. You should be able to stick your arm all the way through this. Okay, so right now, trying to find my little flap. It's on the inside, so just flip your cuff over so that you're looking at the flap. Depending on how you turn it right side out, your flap might already be on the outside or it could be on the inside of your cuff. But this is where we need to be now. We've got the flap on the outside of the cuff. You do not want it turned over the footies right now. So it should be open like this. You can stick your arm all the way through. Now we're ready to attach it to the pants. So I already have my pants sewn together, the waistbands added. When the pajamas are done, we want this part of the cuff with the little flap to be on the back side of the pajamas. So I'm going to turn my pajamas over so I'm looking at the back. And the back has a higher rise and you should have your waistband seam in the back too. So this is the back of my pajama leg. Here's my flap. This is how I want it to look when it's done. So I'm just going to flip this up so right sides are together and pin the cuff to the pajama leg so that I know I have it positioned correctly. Now we're just going to turn these inside out. And pin the rest of the cuff to the pajama leg. So I like to match up the seam in the cuff with the pajama inseam and put a pin right there. And you'll have to stretch the cuffs just a little bit to fit the pajama leg. And then you're going to sew this together and you'll be done. I just sewed on the cuff. And when I sew little cuffs like this, I like to put my presser foot just right inside the cuff, and that's the easiest way to sew it. So this is all sewn, and turn it right side out again. Check to make sure everything's right. So from the front of the pajamas, this is the front, you shouldn't see anything. And that way when they're worn, you'll fold this flap over to cover the toes and it'll go on the top of the foot because you wouldn't want to be stepping on this. And when they're worn with the footies not in place, I normally fold them up like this just so the pants aren't too long. This pattern also includes an option to do the little fold-over flaps on the sleeve cuffs, which is really great to keep baby's hands warm, or if you're trying to deter thumb sucking, or you have a kid with eczema who scratches. I made some for my 9-year-old daughter just because she wanted them and she loves them because it keeps her hands super warm. So that's how you sew a convertible footie pajama cuff. Hope you enjoyed it.